NBC2, News at 11.
Stay out of the water. It's pretty simple.
Stay out of the water. According to experts, there is dangerous bacteria in the Gulf.
And another concern tonight, these new aerials showing you stormwater runoff from the Caloosahatchee. Take a look at this. Out in San Carlos Bay into the Gulf. These are from the Calusa waterkeeper who you just heard from.
So he says the dark brackish water is filled with nutrients which can contribute to red tide. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Christy Soto.
And I'm Trent Bennett. Lower levels of red tide we're seeing here mapped out for you have been found in samples across Charlotte and Lee this past week. You see the colors there.
Today, some people returned to Bonita Beach. Some were just looking around, but others were getting in the water, despite health officials urging you to stay out. NBC2's Alexia Taropoulos reveals the dangers at 11.
And have you guys gone to the beach since the hurricane?
We've been a few times, yeah. It's been a while since we've been able to get down this way.
Although many of you are itching to get back to normal, swimming in the Gulf might not be in the cards just yet.
After hurricanes come through here, stuff can be in our water. And right now it happens to be this flesh-eating bacteria.
Yeah, Vibrio is a type of bacteria that likes brackish water, likes warm water.
Calusa waterkeeper John Cassani says this bacteria can be deadly, especially if you're immunocompromised or have open wounds.
You should avoid the water. Especially in the coastal areas at this time.
You can always find this type of bacteria in the water, but according to John, what makes it worse after a hurricane are the sharp objects and debris that get pulled into the water that you could potentially step on.
If it's treated too late, then the consequences are sometimes dire, does result in death occasionally.
So far in Lee County this year, the Department of Health says there have been 28 Vibrio vulnificus cases. Six people have died from this flesh-eating bacteria.
There's things like arm and leg amputations that occur if the infection isn't treated in time.
They say this increase in cases is associated with Hurricane Ian, but that's not the only concern floating around in the Gulf.
After Hurricane Irma, we had a red tide following about a month later that lasted for more than a year after that event.
Currently, FWC shows red tide blooms affecting parts of Sarasota County. Cassani says that means it could work its way down to Charlotte and Lee County.
Well, if we do have a red tide event, and again, it depends on, you know, what the cell density is, and that'll have an impact on how much gets in the air. But it's just really hard to predict.
Cassani says it's a waiting game. He says there could be a bloom depending on how much rain we get. Reporting in Lee County, Alexia Taropoulos, NBC2.
Breaking right.